Thank you. And yet, Jesus died for us while you and I were yet his enemies. So there's a love that we cannot seem to fathom as human beings, because the love of humans fail. You've been in love. Maybe somebody's failed you, or you may have failed somebody. But there is a love that never fails. It's kind of you and I can't understand. David said, "It is too high. It is too wonderful for me." As a standard today, recognizing that kingdoms come and kingdoms go, empires rise and empires fall, cities exist and then cities are abolished. There is a kingdom, but there is no end. And on it is ruled, who rules, is the King of all kings. When you consider that, whatever he says, creation obeys. In fact, he spoke creation into existence. The only thing that does not abide by the all-powerful voice of God is the crowning glory of his creation, human beings. That's you and me. He gave to us a free will that we have a choice to be able to choose to obey or disobey. And yet how insolent, how stubborn our human heart can be sometimes. When we purposefully know something is wrong and yet deliberately do it anyway. Knowing there are consequences, knowing that it hurts him, we still do it. We need to understand there'll be a day of reckoning. A lot of people seem to ignore that. There is a day of judgment. People think it's a myth now. But the truth of the matter is, one day he will come again. And he sits on a throne, and his name is above every name. How dare we? Deliberately defy his authority and his name. We decide to write the rules of morality and say, this is right, this is wrong. The Bible's obsolete, it's archaic, it's for another generation or another era. And we think we're better than God. On the day that you think you're better than God, then you must be God. We will never bow down to you if you think you're God. And he has a name that is above every name. And that means cancer needs to fall down at his name. That means every disease that has not even been invented yet or conjured by the demonic has to bow down by the name of Jesus. And I believe every person will bow down, every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of the Father. Every knee. One of the characteristics, one of the things that was spectacular when one king would defeat another king, is as much as possible they would save that defeated king, parade him, and make him publicly kneel in obeyance to the king that just won. And I'm believing this, that you and I will see Satan bow down, acknowledging in total defeat that Jesus Christ is Lord of lords, King of kings, and that he is supreme in all things, and then he'll be thrown into hell, and that'll be a horrible thing for him, but it'll be a beautiful thing for the kingdom of God. And so today, with the hands lifted up before you, we acknowledge you, Lord of all, King of kings, creator of heaven and earth, my sure foundation, the true vine, the way, the truth, and the life, my Savior, my healer, the provider of all my needs, my high tower, the rock on whom I stand, the way, the truth, and the life, and you are Alpha and Omega, the soon and coming King, and every knee must bow, every tongue must confess, to declare that you are Lord, and your amazing September. Stupendous. We call it spectacular. We call it a super month in the name of Jesus. And we choose to live our lives at a higher level for you, to bless you in all that we do in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen. How many of you are